tonight, if you'd like to turn there in your Bibles, Exodus 32. We're going to look at a couple of verses in that chapter. We'll look at a couple of verses in chapters 33 and 34, too, tonight. But I mentioned this morning we're going to be talking about the golden calf. The golden calf is quite possibly an event that you heard about if you were in church as a child, in children's church or your Sunday school lessons. Maybe you've taught it to kids, maybe even VBS as we just came through Vacation Bible School. A lesson about Aaron or Moses and the golden calf. It's probably something that most of us in this room have heard about before, and that's okay. Even hearing stories that we're familiar with, it can be a good thing. As we look at it sometimes with fresh eyes, maybe the Lord would show us something that we haven't noticed before. Maybe God will speak to our hearts, even if it's something that we know like the back of our hand. You know, at Christmas, you probably watch It's a Wonderful Life or Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, some kind of special that maybe you watch every year. And it doesn't matter that you know the story, doesn't matter that you've seen it 100 times, it's still something that you enjoy. And some of these old, what we call Bible stories, if you don't mind using that word, some of them are like that. We know them like the back of our hand, but they're just as good every time we lay our eyes on it. And to me, this is one of those stories because there's so much to it. Remember what had taken place up to this. I know last Sunday night, we weren't here because of Bible school, and the week before that, we were actually in the book of Numbers, and we looked at how, we talked about the crybabies. We talked about how God had done so much good for Israel, and yet instead of being grateful, they were whining. They were complaining about the food, complaining about the giants in the land, complaining about so many different things. Am I on? Am I still over here? Is it just this? I only hear myself when I'm right here. Am I on? Can y'all hear me right here? So it's definitely just this. Okay. Well, I'll just stay right here then. I don't know if I muted myself or what I did. Oh, okay. Well, now I muted it. All right. So this is good here? Yeah. Fantastic. Much better. Thank you. But we talked about how God was doing all these things. He led them from Egypt to Mount Sinai. And then he went up and he gave Moses the Ten Commandments. So what we're going to look at tonight is when Moses comes down from Mount Sinai with those Ten Commandments. But, you know, he was up there at Mount Sinai for a long time. We might think he zipped up there, got the commandments, came right back down and said, all right, guys, here's what God wants. But the Bible tells us he was actually up on the mountain for 40 days. I mean, that's more than a month of the Israelites waiting at the base of the mountain. I mean, I can just picture them looking at their watch, tapping their foot, looking up. Where's Moses? When's he going to come down? I mean, they might have thought he'd be up there an hour or two, you know, given the length of time it would take him to walk. Maybe a couple of days, but 40 days. And so we can sympathize with them if they began to get impatient and wonder, okay, maybe he died up there. Maybe it was a fraud. Maybe this was a scam, you know. Maybe he was just trying to get us out here to get back at Pharaoh. Maybe he's disappeared on us. We don't know what's happening. We can't talk to God ourselves. Moses was their intermediary. But they're saying, we don't know what's happened to Moses. And 40 days has passed before this golden calf event takes place. And I think sometimes we might rush through that part, the 40 days, and kind of miss out on why they might be tempted to do what they did. But so let's maybe cut them a little bit of slack and realize 40 days is a long time when you're waiting for Moses to come back down from the mountain. So what did Moses find when he comes down from the mountain? In fact, God told him, you need to get down there and see what these people have done. Well, the first thing we see tonight, number one, we see that Moses finds one graven image. When he comes down from the mountain, he sees that they have fashioned for themselves an idol to worship. If you're in chapter 32, let's look in the first handful of verses. It says, when the people saw that Moses delayed to come down from the mountain, the people gathered themselves together to Aaron and said to him, up, make us gods who shall go before us. As for this Moses, the man who brought us out of the land of Egypt, we do not know what has become of him. So Aaron said to them, take off the rings of gold that are in your ears of your wives, your sons, and your daughters, and bring them to me. So all the people took off the rings of gold that were in their ears and brought them to Aaron. And he received the gold from their hand and fashioned it with a graving tool and made a golden calf. And they said, these are your gods, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt. When Aaron saw this, he built an altar before it. And Aaron made a proclamation and said, tomorrow shall be a feast to Yahweh, to the Lord. And they rose up early the next day, and they offered burnt offerings and brought peace offerings. And the people sat down to eat and drink and rose up to play. And the Lord said to Moses, get down, for your people, whom you brought out of the land of Egypt, have corrupted themselves. They have turned aside quickly out of the way that I commanded them. They have made for themselves a golden calf and have worshipped it and sacrificed to it and said, these are your gods, O Israel, who brought you out of the land of Egypt. And the Lord said to Moses, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. So they say, we don't know what's happened to Moses, so Aaron, we need you. You are the number two guy, so now you're the leader. We want you to make us gods to go before us. All they knew was idolatry. They grew up in Egypt. They knew that the Egyptians had dozens, if not hundreds or more, different gods. And so that's what they knew. Okay, if this god can't do for us, then there's got to be another god. So Aaron, you make us gods that will now go before us. So Aaron said, all right, give me your jewelry. And he takes their earrings of gold and he